Hello, I am Dr. Richie Gupta. I am Director of Plastic Surgery at Fortis Hospital, Shalimar Bagh, Delhi. We do a large number of cases of gender affirmation surgery. Now, what is a gender affirmation surgery? Why would anyone get this surgery done? This is basically because sex and gender are two different things. Sex is what we are born with, like a baby is born and doctors and parents see, and hence they assign the sex to the baby, that this is a male baby or female baby. While what is gender? Gender is our mind. Basically, whatever mind, our brain thinks that we are, whether we want to play a masculine or a feminine role in the society, and that is inborn and that cannot be changed. In most of the patients, sex and gender are in alignment, but in some patients, sex is different while gender is different. Hence, this condition is known as gender dysphoria. Why dysphoria? Dysphoria is a pain. As these patients, they grow up, they realize that their body is not what their mind is. If their body is different, they feel trapped in the wrong body. And as a result, what happens is that they are at odds with their peer groups, like their siblings, like parents, when they go to school with their schoolmates and college mates. This gives rise to a lot of pain, and this pain is known as gender dysphoria. So we treat a lot of patients of gender dysphoria. Now, sex can be changed, but gender cannot be changed. And it's wrong to say that gender can be reassigned. Sex can be reassigned. Gender can only be affirmed by bringing sex into line with the gender of a person. Now, there are two types of surgeries in this. One is male to female surgery and other is the female to male surgery. We carry out three operations. First is the top surgery, in which the breast of tissue is removed so that the patient can go about in the society with a flat chest, wearing t-shirts or tight-fitting garments, and he is accepted as a male in the society and his gender is reaffirmed. The second surgery is removal of female internal organs like the uterus, ovaries, the vagina, etc. Now this hysterectomy is different from hysterectomy that is done elsewhere, because in normal hysterectomy, vagina is not removed, number one. And number two, in this surgery, we also bring the urinary meatus, the urine pipe, forward. Like the male urine pipe is something like 20 to 22 centimeter, while female pipe is 4 centimeters. So we do some work, like we bring this forward by 4 to 6 centimeters, and hence the urine is passed from a more forward position. And this is all we do in the second stage of surgery. In the third stage, we do reconstruction of the penis, scrotum, and the complete urine pipe. Now this we carry out with two methods, either from the forearm or from the thigh. So forearm is known as ref phalloplasty, and from the thigh it is known as ALT phalloplasty. These are the three main operations. Besides, some patients go on for ancillary surgeries like insertion of penile implant, like the chin surgery, genioplasty, rhinoplasty, liposuction, etc. These are ancillary surgeries and these can also be done here. Now female to I was talking about female to male surgery. Now male to female surgery, generally one operation is carried out, that is genital surgery, that is known as feminizing genitoplasty. Now in that, what we do is that we remove the male organs like penis, scrotum, and we recess the urethra, and we make female organs like the vagina, the clitoris, labia, etc. And this surgery is known as feminizing genitoplasty. And another surgery that can be done in females is breast augmentation. Now generally these patients are on hormones, and hence in 1 year to 18 months time sufficient breast enlargement occurs. So most of the patients do not opt for augmentation, but those that want augmentation, yes, we do breast augmentation as well in these patients. Again, there are some ancillary surgeries like facial feminization surgery, in which the forehead can be recessed, the nose can be shortened and made more concave like a female's nose, then angles of jaw and chin, etc. can be corrected. So these are all called ancillary surgeries. So these are basically the main operations that are done as part of gender affirmation surgeries. Generally, to confirm the diagnosis, it is important in these patients of gender dysphoria to first confirm the diagnosis, because there are sometimes psychiatric conditions like manic depressive psychosis and schizophrenia and personality disorders, in which a person can assume that he is a different personality. So that job is done by the psychiatrist. So how do we carry out this treatment? This treatment plan is determined by international criteria. So we follow the 7 standards of care as mentioned by World Professional Association for Transgender Health. So So they have defined a 110 page booklet and the criteria which we follow. So according to that, first the diagnosis should be confirmed, and that is the job of the psychiatrist. And generally we take two psychiatry opinions in the beginning itself, so that it is a patient's diagnosis is confirmed. And after that, there is a waiver of liability affidavit that is also taken, because that gives us the power or the authority to remove the organs which are not normally removed, which are healthy organs which have to be removed as part of this process. So these are the important things. In case a patient is married, then he also requires a permission from his wife, and that is known as the spousal release form, and vice versa. Generally, as I said, that in male to female surgery there are 1 to 2 operations, and in female to male surgery there are around 3 operations. So, and we carry out these operations at interval of 3 months each. So you know, female to male surgery typically will take longer because there are 3 operations, and so it takes about 1 year to carry out all the surgeries. While a male to female can be done in a single operation if only feminizing genitoplasty is done. But if patient also wants breast augmentation, then 3 to 6 months, all the surgeries can be completed.